This is an MPB Think Radio podcast.
Welcome to AutoCorrect, helping you correct your auto problems. I'm Liz Gill, and I'm with the lady auto mechanic, Allison Walker, ASE certified. Hello, Allison.
Hey, Liz.
Today, we're going to talk about beautiful, unique, scary, interesting, whatever drives between your vehicle repair questions. We want to hear from y'all. So call screener, listen, we're going to keep you busy today on AutoCorrect. Y'all start calling now. Don't wait 10 or 15 minutes. Call now. Email us now. We want to hear some of your favorite drives, whether it's in Mississippi or it is in the Southeast or it's in the United States. Maybe you drove out west or in the mountains. We want to hear if you've taken a drive through the Alps or wherever. We want to hear about your farm drives, beach drives, tree line drives, desert drives. We want to hear about some of the drives that you've taken and that you've enjoyed the scenery, or what was it that made that special? You know, Allison, we've got Father's Day coming up Sunday after next. And, you know, that's some of my best memories that I have of my dad was when we went driving somewhere. Sometimes he'd call it sci-fogging around. And we would just get in the car and see where a road went. Or we'd say, you know, let's everybody pack a bag. We're going to go spend a Saturday night somewhere. And we don't know where we're going. And we would just kind of drive to some part of the state to see something. Tell me about a drive that you've enjoyed somewhere either in Mississippi or around the country.
Well, I'm glad you brought up driving with your dad, because I have so many memories of driving with my dad somewhere. One of the more fun memories that I have is he used to have an old Jeep, an old CJ Jeep, and it was pretty beat up and roughed up by the time that we were grown up enough to remember it, and it had a lot of slack in the steering wheel. And we were driving out through some hunting camp territory in the lowest bluffs of Mississippi that run along the delta edge, and I remember going up and down through these hills with these huge ravines on the sides of us with him in the mud, turning that steering wheel as fast as he could back and forth to keep us on the road. And it was at times terrifying and exhilarating all in one. And it was a really, really good time. And that was one of my fondest memories of riding with my dad through the hills of Mississippi. And it was awesome. And like I said, it was very terrifying too. We could have easily gone off the road and just slipped right on down the ravine.
Well, Allison, we asked for calls, and we have got four already. So, folks, if the line is busy, just try again. As soon as someone rolls off, the line will open up, and we can take your call, too. Let's start in Memphis and go to Josh. Josh, thanks for calling AutoCorrect. What's your comment or question?
Sure thing. Well, I was hoping to talk about this experience I had driving, if that's what we're doing right now.
We're doing anything, Josh. What you got?
That's excellent. So I'm an English teacher, and I like to teach abroad. Last summer, I was teaching in Russia, and I'll tell you about one of the best drives that I've ever had. So right at the southern edge of Russia, there's the mountain range called the Caucasus. And in the Caucasus, there are a number of different republics, one of which is on the border between Chechenia and Dagestan. Now, I know those are kind of strange names, but those are smaller regions in the smaller republics in Russia. And so we went driving. My Chechen friends and I, they have these big white fluffy hats that they always wear. But in Chechenia, we were driving along. There was this sheer cliff face as we continued climbing. The elevation rose and rose and rose. And as we were peeking our way through the mountains with this nothing on the rails, right? No railings on the sides of the roads. it was just breathtaking to see the vast majesty that was before you, you know. And as we switched back and forth over and over again, we finally reached our destination in the middle of the mountains, which is a lake called the Jewel of the Caucasus, about maybe 1,200 feet above sea level. And it is the bluest water I've ever seen in my life, like pure topaz. And driving through that is something I'll never forget.
Wow. And you described that so well. I feel like I was right there. That sounds amazing.
Allison, I was gripping my pen. I've got fingernail marks in my hand when he was talking about the switchbacks and with the sheer cliff on the side. Josh, I'm so glad. That was a great call to start our hour with. Thank you so much for sharing that with us.
Sure thing. Hope you guys have a great day.
Oh, you too. We're going to go to our friend Chico, who's calling in from Oxford. Chico, who got to ride in a Lamborghini one time. What's up with you, Chico?
Hey, I wanted to tell y'all about my most favorite drive, the drive I'd like to do later today, and my most memorable. My most favorite drive is from Oxford to 161st Street in New York City. I've done it a lot of times, and it's one of the great things for any American to do. And any good American knows that Yankee Stadium is on 161st Street in New York City. So that's a great drive right there.
Excellent.
30 years ago, I was driving from Bakersfield, California, to Anchorage, Alaska. And I would recommend anyone that wants to go to Alaska, drive is the way to do it. Especially once you get up into British Columbia and you have to choose between the Cassiar Highway or the Alcan Highway. Now, I haven't done it in a few decades, but the Cassiar is 600 miles of gravel. And it's super exciting. You see all kind of wildlife. You have to stop for moose and bears to cross the road and all that sort of stuff. It's a great drive. But I wanted to tell you, since you mentioned the European Alps, I was hitchhiking from Strasbourg, France, down to Italy. And we were in the French Alps, and I got picked up by these farm workers in a creaky, smoky, rusty old Mercedes-Benz van that had seen its better decades. And I got in with them, and I couldn't understand what they were saying. I think they spoke Catalan. But they let me know that they were going to Italy, but I could read the stickers on the inside of the van, and they're all about legalizing marijuana. Okay? So it was a really interesting ride through the Alps, and we got to the border with Italy, and that's when dudes with guns ordered us out of the van, searched the van, searched me, and I remember the sun going down and thinking, I'll never get to see Ole Miss play football again. But much to my surprise, they didn't find anything. They let us back in, and my ride took us down to Italy, and I got out and said adieu to them.
Chico, you know, I need to talk to our program director. We need a whole hour of you. Thank you so much for sharing that with us, Chico.
All right, y'all. Good night.
All right. Bye-bye. Let's go to Gary, who's in Oxford. Gary, what you got for us today for AutoCorrect?
Good morning. I've got two domestic drives for y'all. The first one is from Durango, Colorado to, and I may be mispronouncing it, to Ouray or Ouray, it's O-U-R-A-Y, I think. And it's a U.S. highway that goes up through the mountains, but there's something called the Durango and Silverton Railway, and it's an old-time train that goes to an old mining town called Silverton. But the road goes somewhat, almost parallel to the railroad, which goes somewhat parallel to one of those wonderful Colorado mountain streams. It's a great drive, and I would highly recommend that. Now, here's the other one, and this is reserved for the fall. Everybody knows about the Great Smoky Mountains, but there's a road that is less traveled, as the poet might say. It's called the Hintuga Road. And to get there, you go on the Blue Ridge Parkway from the Cherokee entrance, and you find, it's about 10 miles until you get to what's known as the Balsam Mountain Road. And that's a paved road, and it runs up to a camping area and a picnic area and that sort of thing. But at the end of that road, there's a gravel road, and it's kept in such condition that, you know, anybody in any kind of car, you don't necessarily have to have four-wheel drive, but you do need to be careful. And it's one of the prettiest fall drives that you can ask for, and unless everybody that's listening decides to do it at the same time, it's also little known and worth every minute of.
Gary, I'm so glad that you shared both of those with us. Thank you.
My pleasure. Have a good day.
All right, you too. We're going to have I'm going to get the Atlas out, and I'll have all of these on our website. We're going to have more of our drives and take more of your vehicle repair questions. Hey, Ellison's hanging out for that too. You can always send us emails. Our address is auto@mpbonline.org. Is your car under recall? We'll have a list of ones that are when we come back. You're listening to AutoCorrect on MPB Think Radio.
No matter if you use an app to start your car or still have a flip phone, Everyday Tech can decipher today's technology for tomorrow's solutions. Subscribe now to the podcast using any podcast app or the MPB Public Media app.
You're listening to AutoCorrect with Allison Walker, the lady auto mechanic. I'm Liz Gill. Now, if you want even more AutoCorrect, find our podcast on all the podcasting platforms for your smart device. Hey, today would be a great day. Instead of trying to call in, why don't you send an email? Our address is auto@mpbonline.org. Here are the recalls for the week. There's a 2013-2018 Nissan Altima recall. Dealers will replace the hood latch with a new one for free. The 2016 Land Rover Range Rover Sport. Dealers will update the software and inspect the KV latches and replace them if necessary for free. We've got a Honda 2019 Honda Clarity Fuel Cell Electric and Plug-in Hybrid. Dealers will inspect the rear seat assembly production dates and replace the assemblies as necessary for free. And the 2019-2020 Bentley Bentayga. And dealers will replace the fuel line and quick connectors for free. Last one is the 2020 Mercedes-Benz, Mercedes-AMG cars and SUVs, and dealers will replace the left rear seat back for free. You can find out if your car has a past recall by going to the, say it with me all together, folks, National Highway Transportation Safety Administration's website, which is nhtsa.gov/recalls, and inputting your VIN number. Remind us, Allison, where your VIN number is on your car?
It is on the dash, on the driver's side, and you can see it from looking outside the car towards your windshield, or you can open the driver's side door and there's a little placard that has your VIN number on it inside the door jamb.
All right. We're taking your vehicle repair questions. We also want to hear about your favorite drive, scary drive, beautiful drives, a memorable drive for you. Tell us about it, whether it was in Mississippi or in the United States. Go ahead and send us an email. Our address is auto at mpbonline.org. Allison, we've gotten a couple of emails. One of them, we've been having this back and forth with a friend named Bradley, and it started off with Bradley wanted to some advice on whether he should buy a Camry or stick with his Expedition, and Allison said both, and he decided he was asking about buying a Camry over Carvera, which was an online online car purchasing website. Allison wasn't too much in favor of using that forum, but we got another email and it's got a photo. So it says, "Hi again, Allison and Liz. I wanted to let you know that I purchased a 2013 Toyota Camry this past week using Carvana. They delivered the car to my house on Saturday. Yesterday, I had my local ASE certified mechanic check it out. He said the only thing it would need in a few months was brakes, but that it was a great car. He agreed with what Allison said about Carvana, that once the sale is made, they don't really do much. And he said they sort of sell cars as they are without doing much to them. I love the online experience, though, and not having to talk or negotiate anything. I kept my Expedition as you recommended, and I'm happy I did. Just wanted to let you know about my experience. Thank you again for your advice and your show. Love listening to you and Liz talk about cars."
Awesome. Yeah, thanks, Bradley. I appreciate that information on the Carvana and how it went with that. I'm glad he had a good experience with it.
Well, I'm glad he had a local ASC certified mechanic able to check after it for him.
Yeah, that's awesome.
We'd love for you to send us your emails about your drives. Our email is auto@mpbonline.org. Also, your vehicle repair questions. Email them. You know, anytime when we're not on the air, Allison is so good about checking those and returning those. So we'd love for you to email us. Allison, we got another email. This was kind of a mystery email. It took some detective work, and I did that over the last break we had. Julie emailed Cades Cove with an exclamation point. Have you ever heard of Cades Cove, Allison? I hadn't heard of Cades Cove. It's an isolated valley located in the Tennessee section of the Great Smoky Mountains National Park. The valley was home to numerous settlers before the formation of the park. That's what my Google search was about on Cades Cove. Julie says history and animals. So that is quite interesting to go, and I know a lot of people from Mississippi love going up to the Great Smoky Mountains. We'd love for you to email us your drives, email us your vehicle repair questions. Remember, our address is auto@mpbonline.org. Great, we've got a couple more emails. Elizabeth says her favorite drive, "I love driving through those Mississippi back roads at sunset when the bright orange-red sky starts to peek through the trees. It's simple but beautiful." Oh, Elizabeth, I agree with that so much. I love looking at the sunsets, too. I remember one time specifically, we were driving through the Delta, and the sunset lined up exactly with the fields and the rows, and the shadows that the sun caused was exactly down the fields. It was like a magical convergence with the shadows going down. So, yeah, Mississippi has some great drives, and we hope you will share those with us today. We've got another email that we're going to go to. We've got, this one is from Jim. Jim says, oh, I'm sorry. Have I been saying this wrong? Jim, I am so sorry. Remind Liz that NHTSA stands for National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, not transportation. Well, Jim, I'm so glad that you caught me on that. Allison, we need to double check me when I make mistakes like that. I'm glad Jim is keeping me honest. Allison, you've taken lots of drives out to California and to North Carolina. You drove out to Arkansas recently. Tell us about one of your favorite drives.
One of my favorite drives is another one with my dad. This is one of the first times I ever got to drive. It was in Arkansas, and we were just going up through the mountains for a vacation to visit family and friends, and we were driving through the mountains, and it was gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. That's one of our closest mountain ranges around here, so if there's anyone that hasn't been to Arkansas and drove around in the Ozarks, it's a must drive. It's absolutely gorgeous, and it's a beautiful state to have right next to us with all the natural beauty. And I know you know about it, Liz, because you're from there, but, you know, Arkansas is absolutely gorgeous. There's gorgeous drives all over it, and I've been to a lot of different parts there, so it's amazing.
Excellent. Yeah, I'm extremely biased. Every place is beautiful and a little different. Arkansas has absolutely no beach, so we don't get that nice beach drive. But if you need some mountains pretty quick, in fact, my mom lives on a mountain, Petit Jean Mountain, which is Arkansas's first state park, and it's 6 hours from central Mississippi. So that's a good place to drive to. We've got another email. This one is from James, and he says, a nice drive is south of St. Francisville, Louisiana, in the south and west portion of Mississippi. The new bridge crossing the Mississippi is an awesome sight to see. One day we were driving and it was kind of a misty morning, and coming up on the bridge is like a scene. It was out of fairyland or a fairy tale to see that bridge coming up. Oh, James, thanks so much for sending that to us. That does sound gorgeous. Allison, speaking of bridges across the Mississippi River, no drive is a dud if you're going to cross at Greenville. Have you crossed that Greenville Bridge recently?
A lot, yeah. It's been a couple of times that just here recently that I've crossed it, but I've crossed it many times. But that bridge crossing over to Arkansas is a gorgeous bridge. It's really, really pretty. They should have a name for it or something as a landmark in Mississippi, because it has that. It's the expansion bridge, or what do you call it when it hangs like that?
I don't know. This is the
cables that hold it up.
Yeah, this is suspension, maybe.
Suspension bridge, maybe. But it's beautiful.
We're going to take your vehicle repair questions, and we want to hear about your drives through the mountains, through the deserts, in Mississippi, anywhere. We want to hear about your drives. We also want to tell you about an unreliable car not to buy. We're going to get to that in a bit. You're listening to AutoCorrect on MPB Think Radio.
The information presented on this program is meant to provide general information about the topics discussed and is not necessarily the opinion of Mississippi Public Broadcasting. The information presented does not create any type of relationship between the hosts and guests and the listening audience. Please consult an appropriate professional for guidance about your concerns.
Your old car is kind of like that hairstyle you had in high school. Really cool back in the day. But that old car is still cool when you donate it to MPB Think Radio. Go to mpbonline.org for details. Then sit back and enjoy the ride. Now that's cool.
Thank you for listening to AutoCorrect on MPB Think Radio. Allison Walker, you know her. She's the lady auto mechanic and is our expert. I'm Liz Gill. I hope you've downloaded our app for your smartphone. It's the MPB Public Media app. In addition to listening to our show on the MPB Public Media app, you can click support. There's a button. It even says support and make a contribution. We really rely on these contributions to purchase our national programming and to keep the lights on here, folks. So we really appreciate your contributions to Mississippi Public Broadcasting. Consumer Reports rounded up the poorest used models of the last decade. We got a new list, Allison. Today, we're going to caution you about, and I'm just cracking up, number one, Chrysler Town & Country, which is the Chrysler version of the Dodge Caravan. The reliability has been very bad with Chrysler minivans in the past. Models from 2008 through 2012 were rated much worse than average. Ask me or Allison about it. Please consider reading up on the reliability of this car before purchasing it, as a used car, suggests Consumer Reports. CarComplaints.com is another resource for unreliable car lists. And hey, our friend of the show, Casey Williams, he doesn't have any new reviews this week, but you can watch his video reviews at Auto Casey on YouTube. So we'll have that link on our page. We've been talking about drives today, scenic drives that you've enjoyed around Mississippi or around the country, around the world. Oh my goodness, we've talked at the Caucasus and in Colorado, the Smoky Mountains. We want to hear about your drives. We've got a full list of phone calls, so as one comes off, you can try to call again. We've got another email. I'm not exactly sure what Terry's talking about on this. Terry says in early November, put the glasses down and drive from Natchez to North Nashville on a pretty drive. So what glasses do you think he's talking about, Allison?
He must be talking about the sunroof or the wind, or putting your windshield down, your window down.
Okay. But yeah, the Natchez Trace, man, that is a gorgeous drive. What do you think about the Natchez Trace, Allison?
I love it, and I get on it as much as possible since we're close to it here in the Jackson area. So I love it.
Remember,
highly recommend it.
Remember, folks, you can only go 50. Only can go 50 on the Natchez Trace. So that's the time for the cruising and relaxing. Only go 50. Yep. Do not get a ticket. Let's go to Bill in Fulton. Bill, what you got for us today?
One of the best road trips I've ever been on was getting on Highway 1 below San Francisco and going to Big Sur. I've never seen anything like it. I mean, you know, I've seen the coast road down on the Gulf Coast here where you got nothing but beach on your driver's side going down, but going out to Big Sur and getting on Highway 1 below San Francisco and driving all the way down, there are tons of places. Like every turn we would take, it would be a more picturesque view. Bixby Bridge, Julia Pfeiffer State Burns Park with the waterfall on the Crescent Beach. You've never seen anything like that. They even had cows in a pasture with the ocean as their back fence. Happiest cows I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, and, Bill, I love that drive. I've been there, you know, Monterey, Carmel. You want to drive, but you also want to stop at all those cute little places.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's a blast. And you know, it's up on sheer cliffs and stuff like that, and the blue water crashing on rocks and stuff. I mean, somebody even had like a rock formation with a farmhouse out on top of it, like a tabletop mountain out in the ocean. And you just wonder who lives out there, who lives in these places, you know. And but yeah, stopping Big Sur, just seeing all of that, it just, you know, it amazes you. You always hear about it, but until you experience it, you never know exactly how beautiful it is. But we even tried to get off. I went to Los Angeles, San Diego, and tried to get on Highway 1, but it didn't compare. That up around the San Francisco area is gorgeous. But, you know, my favorite thing in Mississippi is going down to Long Beach and getting on the beach highway there and just driving all the way to past Christian and just going back and forth and just seeing the water and stuff, especially when it's pretty in the spring.
Oh, that is so lucky that we have that in Mississippi. Yeah, Bill, if anybody watches on television, it's the HBO series Big Little Lies. I think they're supposed to kind of live off of Highway 1.
Right.
And you see show starts off with her driving over one of the bridges that kind of does the coastline there.
It's the Bixby Creek Bridge. That's right below, but it's a real famous bridge built in the 30s, and that's in that show. Yeah, we stopped right off of there, and you've got a view off of that bridge like you wouldn't believe. And, you know, like I said, you have to pay to live out there. We found that out. We stopped in Carmel and looked for Clint Eastwood and all that, and, you know, they have dog-friendly beaches where the dogs go unleashed, and they're having the time of their life, and it just... It's a whole different lifestyle out there than what we thought, you know. But yeah, the drive itself, we rented a really nice car and just took off for the day. And I wish we would, you know, have just left San Francisco alone and spent the whole time on the road.
Bill, thank you so much. Oh, I love hearing that memory. Thank you for sharing it with us.
You're welcome.
Let's go to, also to Fulton, let's go to Rebecca. Rebecca, what have you got for us today?
You were talking about crossing Mississippi, and it made me think about a particular time that there was flooding in Memphis, and crossing the I-40 bridge and seeing all the flooding that had expanse that when I went to the top, you know, to the top point on the bridge and just looking at all the flooding, it was just... It's not something that you see every day, but it was just beautiful. It was just staggeringly beautiful to see all the reflection of the water and the sun on the water and such. It was just gorgeous.
That does make for a interesting drive when the landscape changes like that.
But they closed the bridge the next day, so obviously it was just a so I couldn't do it. I did it one day, and that was it.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Rebecca. We appreciate it.
Thank you, ma'am.
Let's go to Les in DeSoto County. Les, I am so glad you got through on the phones. Thanks for keep trying to call. What have you got for us?
Thank you. Good morning, ladies. A couple of interesting drives for you. There's one in New Mexico, and it runs from Charma to Taos over the Kit Carlton National Forest. It's fabulously beautiful, some terrific vistas. US 160 across Colorado over Wolf Creek Pass, and that has some fabulous views as well, and it's quite a climb to the top at about 12,000 feet and then down the other side. And the gentleman who was speaking earlier about the road to Ouray in Colorado, that's US 550. That's the Million Dollar Highway over Red Mountain Pass. And that drive is actually hair-raising. It certainly isn't for the faint of heart. Going up is bad. Going down will really sort you out. And finally, one in Italy that I did many years ago in my Morgan is Stelvio Pass near the Swiss-Italian border through the Alps there. That is spectacular, and there's a fabulous little restaurant at the top. There are some interesting drives. The Kit Carson Forest one is really beautiful. There's plenty of places to stop and take in the view. And Wolf Creek Pass, they actually close the Kit Carson one in winter. Wolf Creek Pass, they will close in winter as well. But if you get there in the fall or the spring, they really are superb drives. Don't rush. Don't hurry. Just take your time. A lot of fun.
Oh, Les, you were worth the wait. Thank you for all of those great suggestions. Folks, we're going to have a list of all of these drives that are being suggested on our webpage. Thank you, Les.
You're welcome, ladies. Have a nice day.
You too. Oh, Allison, where are we going?
I know. That makes you want to go try out, like, all these places, definitely.
Oh, and we need to rent a car. We need to rent a good convertible. Michelle, come with us. She's nodding. We're gonna have a good trip, a good girls trip, and maybe we'll get MPB to send us to Italy. Let's take one more call before the break. Now, remember, when a call goes off, that means a line is free. We'd love for you to share your drives, suggestions. Our phone number is 1-877-MPB-RING. That's 1-877-672-7464. Let's go to Shirley in Starkville. Shirley, what have you got for us today?
Well, I wish I had only one scenic drive to share, but there are two sort of favorites. One is in Michigan. Well, actually, the drive began in Toledo, Ohio, and ended in Lansing, Michigan. And it was in the winter. I love trees. And, oh my gosh, the snow had recently fallen on the trees all along that route. And it was just so peaceful, just nothing but, beautiful trees and freshly fallen snow on either side of the expressway. So that's one. And the other, someone I think has mentioned before, the Natchez Trace. And every time I drive on the trace, I tell myself that I'm going to stop at each of those little areas where there, there are signs for the significance of each of those areas, and I seem never to have the time. So I'm going to make time one of these times that I drive down the Natchez Trace to read those signs and see the significance of those areas. But again, beautiful, beautiful trees. And so, two M's there, Mississippi and Michigan.
Oh, Shirley, that is fantastic. And, you know, that's what, for me, that's what a Sunday drive is. Just taking a little extra time and to see the world. Thank you so much for sharing that with us.
Well, thank you for your program.
We have been discussing driving and drives. We're also taking your vehicle repair questions. Just a few minutes more left in the show. Remember, you can always send us an email, auto@mpbonline.org. What's in the news? Allison, you're really going to want to hear this one. This is AutoCorrect on MPB Think Radio.
Hi, I'm Jason Klein from Fix It 101. If you ever thought about changing the doorknob or fixing a leaky faucet, some jobs just aren't that difficult, and yes, you can do it. If you want to find out how to do those things, listen to Fix It 101, podcast everywhere.
Get your MPB car tag anytime. It doesn't even have to be up for renewal. Simply go to your county office to sign up. When you get an MPB car tag, a portion of the fee helps MPB continue to educate, inform, and entertain Mississippians. For details, visit mpbonline.org/car tag. We'll see you on the road.
This is AutoCorrect. Now, if you've missed any of our live program, you can listen to the whole show at autocorrect.mpbonline.org. What's in the news? Oh, man, I wish I'd gotten Michelle to punch up a drum roll. But Allison, did you know that this week is National Automotive Service Professional Week. So I wish we had a cake for you.
That's awesome.
We want to appreciate you as our automotive service professional. And folks,
thank you.
Allison is the professional, ASC certified. I am Liz Gill, just here to answer the phones. But we've got four calls on the line. So let's go ahead and I did our news. Let me get everything straight. I did our news. Let's now go to Ken, who's calling from Port Gibson, a beautiful place itself. Ken, what's your comment or question for the show?
Well, Liz, my wife and I, since retirement, we've been all over the country traveling in the RV, and we've found some awesome rides out west and the west coast and the east coast, all over. But since this is Mississippi Public Broadcasting, I'd like to emphasize the rides in Mississippi. One of the most beautiful ones in the springtime, especially, is from Port Gibson to Rodney. And you go out Rodney Road, and it's a very curvy road all the way down by Windsor Ruins and Alcorn, by the Alcorn Chapel there, and then on down into Rodney. And there's thousands of dogwoods and red buds blooming, and it is an awesome ride. And you're in shade. My wife and I call it the deep, dark forest. You're in shade 90% of the way, and, you need air conditioning. It's a perfect ride. And then the other ride that we like so much in Mississippi, I think was mentioned a bit earlier, and that's riding 90 on the coast. It's really lovely down there.
Ken, that is fantastic. Allison, are you up for a road trip?
I'd love to go down to the Windsor Ruins again. I've been down there, and it is beautiful in that area. I love it.
Well, let me know, and I'll give you the 50-cent tour when you get here.
Okay. Ken, you know we will.
Very good. And don't forget fried chicken at Mr. D's when you get
there. Love it.
Thank you so much, Ken. We appreciate you calling in. Let's now go to Kinsel, who's calling from Vicksburg. What have you got for us today?
I was actually calling about a car repair question, but I also want to say I'm an Alconite. I went down to Alcorn, and that ride down to Rodney is an awesome ride. I go down for football games all the time. And Ken was telling the truth. That is an awesome, lovely ride.
Well, Kinsel, we've got your ride. Now give us your auto repair question.
Okay. I recently had some brake pads put on, and now I kind of hear some knocking on my front passenger side, kind of when I come to a stop, and I was wondering what possibly could that be?
What I would do is take it back to the place that you had the brake pads and tell them that you're having that problem. Maybe they left off the little piece of metal bracket that goes on there to keep your brake pad in place. And perhaps they accidentally left that off and just have them check that again. So I'd go back to the place that did your brake pads and say that when you're stopping, you're hearing a knocking noise. They should know what that is and be able to fix that.
Okay. Also, when I hit a bump or something, it's kind of a hard hit. So I wondered, did that have maybe something to do with my shocks or?
Yeah, it sounds like maybe your struts are worn and it's time to replace them. Usually, your struts start to go bad around 200,000 miles on most vehicles. So if you have around that mileage, then it's highly likely.
Yes, I'm around that mile. This is a 2004, so yes, I am.
Yep. That sounds great.
All right. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Kinsel. Let's do our last call and go to Graham in Starkville. Graham, thanks for calling into AutoCorrect. What have you got for us today?
I just heard people talk about riding in a Ferrari and doing a number of different things. I've traveled all over the continent from the Yukon to the Mexican border. at least. But one of the most memorable rides that I ever had, 1944, a young man that worked for my grandfather in southern Ontario. We're right in the middle of southwestern Ontario, halfway between Toronto and London, out in remote, beautiful rolling farmland. But anyway, he had a 25 or 30-year-old Model T Ford, and we didn't drive very far, but it was over such rugged terrain. It was just a dirt road. It wasn't even graveled, as I recall. And I just remember that as one of the great moments of my life to have had a chance to ride in Henry Ford's, one of his originals. And I probably only drove in, we might have driven in it twice, but the one time I remember was just an hour playing around and driving back through the countryside adjacent to rugged creeks and open farmland. Just thought I'd mention that, since most people think of much more modern things, that there are a few of us around that still remember how it used to be. Thanks.
Thank you, Graham. That is very cool. What an interesting ride. Allison, we had a couple more emails. Sophie wanted to say here on Cades Cove in the Great Smoky Mountains. And Margaret also wanted to say how much she has enjoyed driving on Highway 1 from San Francisco traveling south. Let's see. I have loved all sorts of... I like making sure I look out the window. You know, I had kids with the Game Boys, and their heads are always down. So I want to make sure everybody, you know, kind of keeps their heads up, looks out the window. I love passing some kind of an alpaca farm or noticing something interesting on the side of the road. That's always a fun thing for me. Allison, what do you like to look at and look for when you're on a drive?
I just love the view, and I'm a mountain girl, so I love to go through mountain territories and to see the views and the ridges and the valleys and the little towns as you're coming up to a town, and you'll see a valley and a little town down in a scenic view. I absolutely love that. But mountain views, and then like when you get up in the Blue Ridge and the Smoky Mountains to see the clouds, the way they cover the mountains is absolutely gorgeous. One of my favorite views. So that's what I love. And, of course, seeing the wildlife, you know. I've been up through the Rockies and seen rams on the side of the road and antelope and mule deer. And that is always awesome to see all these different wildlife creatures on the side of the road.
All right, and the last word is from Michelle McAdoo. She likes looking at the water. So that's going to wrap us up for today's AutoCorrect. Jay White, you earned your keep today as our call screener, and Michelle McAdoo, what a fantastic team they are. We could not put on this show without them, but it's mostly Allison Walker, who you can follow on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram as the Lady Auto Mechanic. I'm Liz Gill, and I hope you join us each Thursday for AutoCorrect on MPB Think Radio.